Evening, everybody. It's Friday night, which means we are multi-class invitational night, and we are at Zolder, good field tonight. 16 cars so far. I don't think anybody else is going to be joining us. I think everybody's here. But regardless, good field, and I think split pretty evenly down the middle. Not quite. I think just a couple of more GT4s than GT3s. But regardless, on a track this tight and small, that's plenty of traffic, and that's going to make it, you know, difficult and fun and all of that good shit. Let's see, right off the bat, Dippin and I are extremely concerned and more than a little bit jealous about the strength of the Mercs in this race. We did Bathurst last week and the Mercs were strong. We're doing Zolder this week and the Mercs are strong. And we're both wondering if we've chosen the wrong cars. So we're going to find out about that. But even if that's the case, we are not going to be boring curmudgeons choosing the obvious power cars for the entire season, because those people who do that are losers, is really what it comes down to. So anyone who is driving a Merc for the upcoming Club Series, we look down on with disdain, and consider them unoriginal and lacking imagination. So, you know, they picked a car that does the driving for them because they lack the skill to get around the track quickly on their own. I don't know what else you can say. Not pointing any fingers at, you know, Matrix or Plan B or Hirish, you know, or Arthix, you know, all you guys, I'm sure, top-notch individuals when you're not in a Merc, but for now you are. GT3s are out qualifying right now. GT4s will go out in just a few minutes, and you know, we'll see how it goes. Second race that I've done with the McLaren so far, and it's a pretty good solid car. It's got its quirks that I still have to learn. I think the braking seemed a little bit funky on it. I've been struggling, particularly in Sector 1, figuring out where the exact braking and turn-in points and all that are. So that's a little bit strange. And you know, we'll just see how it goes. But it's going to take some getting used to. There are definitely some things in the setup that you can't adjust that I wish you could. I feel like having a little bit more control over the differential would be really nice in this car, but you can't adjust it at all. And anyway, so minimal setup controls on it in some areas that I would kind of like. But other than that, the car is pretty solid, it seems, all over the place. It seems to struggle a bit on faster curbs. So not really here at Zolder. It's taking them just fine for the most part, it seems. But when you have higher speed curbs, like we were dealing with last week at Bathurst, both the GT3 and GT4 McLaren seem to struggle with those a bit. It's something that's going to take a little bit of playing with to figure out how to correct that. It has a tendency that when you catch them, it just sucks the front wheel right in further into the curb. So. Oh, Matrix is taking up the challenge and saying that next week at Monza he will drive anything but the Merc, which just screams Janetta to me. Yeah, that's what just screams Janetta. Janetta will be a fantastic car at Monza. Matrix, don't you worry about it. You're going to do great. Like I care. He's a freaking great driver. Doesn't matter what he drives. He's good. He's fast. You know, what are you going to do? That would be a challenge, Matrix, no question about it, to drive that. But if you've got the balls to do it, then by all means, give it a try. But yeah, that'll be kind of tough. You got your snack, bud? To keep you busy?
Thank you. session is now over. I've been validated.
Oh, nice lap, Dippin. Way to get up in there. Still, look at that. I'm freaking 2 seconds behind Plan B and Matrix. Guys, those are insane laps. Okay, I need to do math. Okay, 37 laps tops. Let's call it 84 liters will be more than enough. That's going to frankly be too much, I think, but. Twenty-one, twenty-two, one, twenty-two, seven, twenty-two, one, twenty-two, seven, twenty-nine, twenty-one, five, 84 liters, tire set 10, tire set 11, dumbass.
30 seconds.
That's why we check. Okay, I think that's all okay.
30 seconds.
You know, the other thing that I wish I could adjust on the McLaren that I can't is the brake bias. That kind of sucks. Subby. Oh man. Oh, that sucks, man. That really sucks. I mean, I assume it's going to teleport him. But I'm guessing there's damage too, I would think. By the way, in a race like this, I don't really mind being behind time-wise to Matrix Plan B, that kind of thing. I'm not a naturally fast driver. I can't just jump in a car and be quick. It takes me a lot of preparation, which I don't get for a race like this. Okay, let's be careful. Who all went off there? I couldn't tell. Well, I guess Dippin' was one of them, because I've got nothing but Mercs in front of me. Irish, thanks for not killing me. Okay, Subby, now that we got all those guys out of the way, go racing. Well, that was not good.
Car on the left.
See ya, Irish. Well, I kind of turned this into a clusterfuck, didn't I?
Clear on the left.
Irish, nice job there, bud. Both gave plenty of room.
Sector 2.
I suspect when I watch the replay of that spin, it will be because I held the brakes too long. Another little bobble there, though. That is, that's the corner that on this track that makes me most wish that I could adjust the differential. This doesn't feel quite right. Ratman, if you can get up here fast enough, take the inside. I don't think you're going to, though. Careful, bud.
Faster car approaching. Watch out. Clear on the right.
Mm-hmm. Go for it, Jane. Whoa. There is definitely still something with the braking or what, I'm not sure, that I don't have figured out on this car. Because I shouldn't be spinning like that on those two corners that I have. I know this track pretty well. It's not like... Chadlow, that was a bit much, I think. Up here, angry.
Faster car coming up behind you.
Yeah, you were too nice there, bud. Either too nice or you just overcooked it a little bit, one of the two. We dropped three cars? I don't get that. Angry I get if he dropped, because he just had surgery literally on his hand. So we were a little bit surprised he was going to be able to race tonight at all. So I'm not surprised if he started struggling, because it was giving him problems. Plan B is only 16 seconds behind me, halfway through the race. That's a little bit disgusting. I mean, I know I had a couple of spins, and this is a short track, but still. That's a little bit embarrassing. Plan B, you're embarrassing me. I hope you're happy. What did I tell you about rubbing my own jealousy in my face? You merc guys, I tell you. Maybe I can suddenly get 2 seconds a lap faster in the second half of this race. That's possible. Damn you, Matrix. You're even worse. Okay, Jane, come up here.
Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the left. Clear on the left. Faster car is approaching. Watch out.
Take the inside, Matrix. Take the inside.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
You know what? I actually screwed that up. I treated Matrix like a GT3 passing me instead of me being a lapped car. Sorry about that, bud. I'm gonna screw around here and let Transplant pass me. Matrix up there running 37s. Yeah, I deserve that.
Clear on the right. Pit window is closing down.
Clean laps, clean laps. Can't do much if you don't run those.
The car behind you. Sector 3.
I had to do that, but I hated to because it cost me a lot of time to hire a It's actually making good progress on him. Be nice to at least have a shot at him. I don't know if I do now. But that's what you get for being lapped. Missed that braking marker. Yeah, I wanted to try it. I think I can take more curb there. This is probably not the best time to be practicing it. Well. I got distracted there because Irish just picked up a drive-thru. You're gonna catch me, Jane. You're gonna catch me here or after. One ticket.
Car on the left. Bear on the left.
One thing I'm starting to notice about this McLaren that's going to take some practice is that I think it's more sensitive to aero braking. Than any of the other GT4 cars I've driven. Except maybe the KTM. And by aero braking, I mean beginning to let off the brakes earlier in a straight line as the aero grip on the rear reduces to threshold brake, which would probably be the more accurate term. In other words, it's more sensitive to threshold braking. Might be the better way to put that.
Faster car coming up behind you.
I was expecting to jump in there, Ratman. Were you just playing it safe, I assume? That's my guess. Late in the race, looks like a like about a 25 second lead over Bangers. And he didn't want to risk it. That's what I'm assuming. Because normally I would expect Ratman to slide up in there. Irish, did you pick up track limits? Was that why you got that drive-through? Oh, I don't want any part of this.
Car on the left. Clear on the left. Yellow flag in sector one.
Well, I really hope I didn't screw up that fight between Bangers and Trigger. right there in the first chicane. I really didn't want to be in the way of them, but the timing of it really sucked. I tried to stay off to the right there as much as I could and let them go through. I don't think I got in the way, so to speak, but I might have screwed up the timing of trigger, which would suck. Let me think. What do I want to say? Well, it was fun. You know, Zolder, tight track, lots of traffic. That's how that goes. Who all dropped out? Angry did. Yeah, I knew that. Dippin' must have right off of the beginning. Yeah, I want to see that here in a second. I want to watch that replay of the first lap and take a look and see what happened there. Looks like Ace did as well. No, I don't think he ever started. But before we get to those, let's see. Sunday, our league race is at Hungaroring, and it's in the rain. And I will quote Cruz Davis, who I think summed up nicely how our preparation has gone for this week when he said that the Lambo is garbage there under these conditions. And he's absolutely right. I believe between the two of us so far, I hold the record for completing 12 laps without spinning or otherwise putting my car into a wall. So our hope is to, in the next 2 days, to get to the point where we can actually finish the race. That's honestly our only goal. Whether or not we can make that happen, I have no idea. The Lambo just sucks there in the rain. It's horrendous. Okay, I want to first of all, I want to go look at replays. We'll see what happened. Spawn as older. And speed, if you watch this after the fact, I'm absolutely going to look at your formation lap on slow motion. Because in the best interest of making fun of those who we love the most, that is that's what this is all about. Coming up shortly, I think. That's awesome. That deserves a better look. Yeah, Warm those tires, bud. Get them warmed up. That's fantastic. I want you to know you are not the first person in this community that I have seen put themselves into a wall on the formation lap. You're not the first. But that was really excellently done. Okay. Let's see. I want. I want dipping. I want to see what happened. It happened up there. So we've got Shadlow and Angry. All looks good, all looks good. Shadlow comes out a little bit, and Angry comes in a bit. Well, I'd say that's on Angry, but I can kind of see why it happened as well. Ratman goes off there to the left and starts coming on, and this is I'm thinking of a line from Jurassic Park just because I watched it the other day, but where Alan says, "Look how they shy away from a predator like a flock of birds." That's kind of what Angry was doing. He was hesitant, I'm guessing, about Ratman coming back on, so tried to give himself a little bit of breathing space and just came over a little bit too far. Because he didn't know at that point whether Ratman was going to spin or what. And that probably made him react. Probably a little overreact is what I'm guessing, which is what put him into Shadlow. It's hard to, his focus at this moment, in other words, is to the left, you know, because Ratman is right there filling his view, and he in Angry's mind, he'll be the primary danger. So that's what he's worried about. And he probably didn't even realize that Shadlow was in that close to him. That's my best guess anyway. That honestly, that's unfortunate. In other words, I don't think that's a case of where someone is trying to squeeze the other driver. That is a driver who is trying to react to something that is happening in the moment, and the reaction unfortunately takes him into another car, and that's where Dippin gets killed. Well, that really sucks. What else do I want to look at? I want to look at that last lap and see whether I got in the way of Trigger there. Yeah, I just caught too much of the curb. I mean, I know it was probably because I was a bit on the outside and he was trying to avoid me, but and took him inside a little further than he wanted to be. But I think that's pretty clean. I certainly gave him as much room as I could. Sorry, Trigger, that was just bad timing all the way around. More than anything else. And a gift to Bangers. So, Trigger, my apologies, and Bangers, you're quite welcome, I suppose, is the way to do that. So, anyway, that's it for tonight. Thanks all. We'll see you on Sunday, hopefully. And cross your fingers that I can get through the race, and so can Cruz in our piece of shit rain Lambos, because they're not good. Otherwise, we will catch you later. Have a good night.